You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me.
Good morning, Galville School. My name is Carly.
And I am Gabby. Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would everyone please remain standing for a moment of silence.
Good morning, Colonel. Would everyone please raise their right hand and repeat the BART pledge after us.
I promise to be accepting, responsible, and kind.
Everyone may be seated now.
Let's go over our weather center. What's going outside today, Aiden?
Good morning, everyone. How is today's weather? Back to the studio.
Thanks, Aiden. It is now time for a morning announcement. Here is our lunch menu. It is a new month. November is the 11th month and the second to last month of the year. In the Julian and Gregorian calendars, the fourth and last month to have the length of 30 days.
With all new this month comes a new theme, and this month our theme is kindness, which will be our final word in the BART pledge.
According to the Oxford Dictionary, kindness is defined as the quality of being friendly, generous, and considerate. We will learn more about it this month.
Coming up this month, school store will be open on Thursdays. Our day is this Friday.
We have half days on the 13th and 14th for parent-teacher conferences, and no school starting November 27th for Thanksgiving break.
Let's listen to a read aloud with Dr. Austen.
The Invisible Boy by Trudy Ludwig. Illustrated by Patrice Barton. The Invisible Boy. Can you see Brian, the invisible boy? Even Mrs. Carlotti has trouble noticing him in her classroom. She's too busy dealing with Nathan and Sophie. Nathan has problems with what Mrs. Carlotti calls volume control. He uses his outside voice inside too much. Sophie whines and complains when she doesn't get her way. Nathan and Sophie take up a lot of space. Brian doesn't. When the bell rings for recess, Mika and JT take turns choosing kids for their kickball teams. The best players get picked first, then the best friends of the best players, then the friends of the best friends. Only Brian is left, still waiting and hoping. JT glances in Brian's direction and just as quickly looks away. We've got enough players for each team, he tells the others. Let's play ball. In the cafeteria, Madison and her friends talk about her birthday party. The rope swing over this pool was awesome, says JT. Yeah, so is the water slide, adds Fiona. That was the best pool party ever. I'm so glad you guys had fun, said Madison. Everybody did, except Brian. He wasn't invited. At choosing time, while the other kids play board games and read, Brian sits at his table, doing what he loves to do best. He draws fire-breathing dragons, scaling tall buildings. Space aliens locked in intergalactic battles. Greedy pirates digging for treasure. and superheroes with the power to make friends wherever they go. On Monday morning, Mrs. Carlotti introduces Justin, a new student, to the class. Brian smiles shyly at him. Some of the other kids sneak looks at Justin, trying to figure out if he's cool enough to be their friend. They haven't quite made up their minds yet. At lunch, Madison and JT watch Justin eat with chopsticks. "What's that?" asks Madison as she points at Justin's food. And the kids laugh. All of them, that is, except Brian. He sits there wondering which is worse, being laughed at or feeling invisible. The next day, when Justin goes to his cubby to put away his backpack, he notices a piece of paper with his name on it. At morning recess, Brian finds a piece of chalk on the ground and starts drawing away. "Hey, Justin," Emilio calls out from the tetherball court. "You're up next." "Sorry, I gotta go," says Justin. "By the way, that's a really cool drawing," he adds before taking off. Back in class, Mrs. Carlotti asks the kids to team up in twos or threes for a special project. The kids scurry around the room to pair off. Brian heads towards Justin. "I'm already with Justin," says Emilio. "Find someone else." Brian looks at the floor, wishing he could draw a hole right there to swallow him up. Mrs. Carlotti gives the class directions for the project. "Your assignment is to work together to write a story about what you see in that photograph." "Whoa, cool," says Amelia. "What kind of people do you think would live in houses like that?" "I don't know, but I bet Brian could draw them to go with our story," says Justin. Brian smiles as he takes out his lucky pen. It's lunchtime again, Brian's least favorite part of the day. Another 20 long minutes of kids talking and laughing with everybody else but him. "Brian," he hears someone shout. "Hey, Brian, over here." Brian turns and sees Justin waving him over. Emilio nods at Brian as he makes room for him at the table. Maybe, just maybe, Brian's not so invisible after all.
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye.